Listen, it's what you hear it. Listen, it's what you hear it. Listen, X gon' give it to ya. Fuck, wait for you to get it on your own. X gon' deliver to ya. Knock, knock, open up the door, it's real. If the non-stop pop out, I'm stainless steel. Go hard getting busy with it. But I got such a good heart that I make the motherfucker wonder if you get it. Damn right, can I do it again? Cause I am like
fucking Damer! Call me back.
Oh, the fuckhead.
Damer!
Timothy!
What's going on, bro?
Not much, man. Just at the workshop working on the Supra. How about yourself?
Just in Sydney, bro. Quick one for ya.
Yeah.
Alright, so you might be asking yourself, who is Tim? Tim is my mate from over east that I'd never met before going over there. Pretty much, he had an MFD unit back in the day for sale when I was building this R34. Yeah, ended up getting sold on me, but we sort of still stayed in contact. I'm guessing he found out about me through the YouTube channel because that's really the period that it started taking off. We ended up exchanging numbers and he pretty much pulled me out of the shitter every time I needed help. Yeah, any car advice, he had an answer. I was at the workshop and he just called randomly about some random topic and he's like, why don't you just, at the end of the conversation, I was like, why don't you just come to Sydney? I'll pick you up from the airport, you got a place to stay. And yeah, that's how it all happened.
If this were to happen, I'd be in Sydney at 21:50 tomorrow night.
What's 21:50?
9:50 p.m.
Yeah, I can pick you up.
What do I do?
I can pick you up from the airport, bro.
Man, this is gonna be fucking sick. Like it was actually meant to be. Like when you think about it, like why the fuck would you call me? It's like 9 o'clock here.
Yeah, man. It's fucking 11:30
here, bro. Yeah, I got an assignment due tomorrow, so I'll just have to smash it out tonight.
Please allow me to introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long, long year. Stole many a man's soul of faith. I was around when Jesus Christ had his moment of doubt and pain.
Stop me from approaching. I don't give a fuck what your reputation is. I just repeat this night and do it all over again. These are the thoughts in my mind. Hope you don't think I'm crazy. Just don't ever try to play me. These are rules I'm engaging. I sit back in the back and wait for the perfect time. See, you don't have the time. Wish I could reverse the time. Give me time. Pretty little thing. Give me love by the sippy cups. Hit me up. Finish up. Sip it up. This is lust. Fuck up in this bitch. Said I need that. Need that. Shorty caught my eye. Said I need that. Need that. Let me get a feel, man. I'm
how are you, gentlemen? Damon, finally meet you, man.
How are you?
This is
Damon.
Anthony, how are you?
Oh, yeah?
Joking.
Hey,
Cobb,
I'm Connor. Nice to meet you.
Damon,
what's going on?
Oh, not much,
time we spent together in our prime. We were birds of a feather, different kind. We were laughing through the pain. You were never once so bad. Cut the cord, it kept us.
Yeah, the boys.
Count up the bands, sticking up. No rubber band is big enough. Tennis so heavy, can pick it up. Came with the gang, I'm here, yeah. I see you with the lids. Where's my root mysterious? My whip from Fast Furious. Curtains we yell on tears. I get the calms, period. Covered in ice, Siberia. I'm at the top of the pyramid. Bitch, I'm a star, I'm serious. We gonna play serious.
Smashed out that paint job, didn't he?
Yeah, can't
believe. What did he sell? 2 days?
Sorry?
2 days of prep work or 2-3 days?
Oh, it probably took about a week.
Yeah.
We stripped a lot of it in his house and then...
What time is it then?
It is 4:10 a.m.
4:10 a.m. Doors opening.
Doors closing. Elevator going down.
Is that for the nap in the car?
Yeah.
Enjoy that one. See you, mate.
See you.
Doors opening.
On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. My love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again.
Boy.
Morning.
Yeah, it is gorgeous out here.
Trip is about the GDR festival, so I'll give you guys a bit of a backstory. We roll into the festival and it's pretty dead, so give it an hour or two, we got there pretty early. Cars start rolling in and by the end of it, at its peak, there was probably a couple of hundred GDRs. Everything from a bone stock car all the way up to a fully built, who knows how many hundreds of thousands of dollars spent on it. There was a couple of cars in there that I followed on the internet from when I was a really, really young kid that I saw, and I was like, fucking awesome to see in real life, I won't lie. And I think I've got one of those cars as a screensaver in our home desktop as well. I'll have to check it out. But anyways, where I'm going with this whole dreamy talk is, I was that kid that had his headphones in or earphones in, you know, listening to music, picturing myself driving an R32 GDR and R34, and a couple of years later, started working and sort of found a way to own it. So I've got the poor man's GDR, and I did buy a real 32 GDR shell that I'll show you guys later on in the future. And one thing I really want to say is, this is going to sound insane to those people that are dying to have it and that they don't, but when you own it, trust me, it becomes just a car. And why I say that is there's a lot of factors that ruin it. A lot of that I saw at the festival itself is you get hungry for more. Now, I'm sure a lot of those people with the top tier GTRs have done well in life or whatever, but for your average person to afford that, you need a full-time job to literally pay for this car. And like, I'm talking $150,000, $200,000 builds before you even purchase the car. So you're talking $300,000-$400,000 for a car. That, in my mind, is absolutely insane. And another thing that ruins it is the fucking internet, because everybody has 1,000 horsepowers, and 1,000 horsepowers is expensive. It is not reliable for the most part. It's very expensive to build and it's very expensive to maintain. And I guess because you're always, you know, people are just saying, it's like, get vaccinated. It's sort of the same thing. Like you need 1,000 horsepower, you need 1,000 horsepower, and you start believing it. And then after a while, well, your 600 or 700 that you might have, all of a sudden you're not happy with it because the internet's ruined it for you. So personally, I'll be honest, after about 2 hours, I'd seen enough on the festival. It's amazing. I'm very happy that I got to meet a lot of people. That was the biggest highlight of the weekend, is the people I got to interact with. I even met people that watched the YouTube channel. But for the most part, the cars, as crazy as that might sound and as passionate as I am about these cars, the internet has absolutely ruined it, in my opinion. The need for more and how expensive everything has gotten to the point that you genuinely cannot enjoy it. I was left speechless. I was walking around and I spotted a car that left me absolutely speechless. And I'll give you guys a condensed version of this story. It was 2018, I was in Serbia. My best mate Danny flew in to come visit me. And I somehow convinced him, let's go to Greece on one of those, you know, tour thingies where you go with a bunch of people. 4 or 5 days into this trip, and my brother breaks up with his girlfriend. So we go out, we celebrate, we get a bit drunk. And next day, we're supposed to go to the shipwreck. Everybody's seen that on the online, photos, videos, you name it. And we're so hungover, we're dying. We're not going to that freaking shipwreck. So the guys that were above us, the room above, walked downstairs, knocked down our door, and they're like, look, we're going to this beach called St. Nicholas. Do you guys want to come with us? It's only a bus ride away. It's like, I've got nothing else to do, let's do it. So we go on all the water activities, we get gypped by the locals, and then we're just sort of chilling on the sunbeds, and I hear this thing. But mind you, on the bus from Serbia to Greece, I remember telling Danny, I was like, dude, imagine if there was like a GDR hidden away somewhere on this island, and you wouldn't believe it. I turn around and it's an R35 GDR. So I go up to the owner, introduce myself, and see, the guy's got a bit of an Aussie accent. His name's Dom. And turns out he's traveled, what, maybe 10 or 15 countries at that time through Europe, maybe 10 or 15,000 kilometers. Originally, the car was from Japan. It got shipped to Europe. He drove around Europe and he said how he's going to send this car back to Australia. And you can probably see where the story's going.
Yo! Calderón, Don Omar, los bandoleros.
Lo que se diga, te diga, William Landrón y yo somos socios de la avenida. Soy bandolero como el mister politiquero que se robó todo el dinero y lo postularon de nuevo.
So as you just saw, the same car that I saw in Greece, I saw now in Sydney. Both were very spontaneous last minute trips. That car and the story behind it, and getting to speak with Dom or the owner once again, sort of just like, just a bit of a reminder for me, to a bit of a tap on the shoulder to tell me, like, make your dream happen. And if you've been following me long enough now, you will know that my biggest dream is to travel. My biggest dream is to travel in the R34, to meet people, try new experiences. It's not about having the fastest car or the prettiest car. It's just, that is my biggest dream. So
So yeah, that was the highlight of my whole weekend, I would say, is seeing that car again, just as a bit of a reminder. So I think that's gonna slowly conclude this video. Hopefully it wasn't too boring. In the next video, we've actually got a full interview with Anthony from Dartane Racing. We're talking business, we're talking what it takes to build a car as such. I really look up to Anthony and all his work, but before I conclude the video, I'd just like to give a massive thank you to Tim for picking me up, for hosting me, showing me around. It was very awesome of you, and I definitely owe you one. I'd also like to thank Terry for taking me for a spin in the N1s, both the 33 and the 34. By the way, if you've got deep pockets and you want a collection of 32, 33 and 34 N1s, contact GDR Sales Australia. Tim will get back to you if you're serious. And yeah, cheers to the boys over at Dartane Racing for the good times. We'll see you next Sunday.
Tío, el no juzgar no se les agradece.